and welcome to The Written Word, a product of Harvard Medicine Magazine. I'm Molly McDonough from the Office of Communications at Harvard Medical School. We're here today with physician researcher Jagmeet Singh, who goes by Jag, a professor of medicine at Harvard Medical School and a cardiologist at Massachusetts General Hospital. Jag has joined us to discuss his book, Future Care: Sensors, Artificial Intelligence, and the Reinvention of Medicine. Future Care explores how technologies such as wearable devices, AI, and telehealth are transforming healthcare, weaving in insights from patient stories and his work as a cardiologist. Jag writes about how we can understand and adapt to this changing landscape while also working to make the future of healthcare more accessible, equitable, and accountable. Jag, thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me, Molly. Delighted to be here.
So can you give us an example of an emerging digital technology that has influenced that work as a cardiologist and may have influenced the health outcomes of your patients?
For sure. So, you know, I'm within cardiology, I'm called a cardiac electrophysiologist. So for those who don't know what that is, that's somebody who actually implants pacemakers and defibrillators, puts catheters up in the hearts and burns circuits that cause life-threatening arrhythmias or atrial fibrillation. The devices we implant in patients who need pacemakers and defibrillators, these devices within them have a spectrum of sensors. These sensors can monitor heart rate, physical activity, respiratory rate, fluid levels in the body, beyond several other measures. And some of the work we did along with the industry was largely in streamlining one of these integrated sensors that could actually predict which patients were to develop heart failure 30 days before they actually develop it. So this gives you enough time to actually intervene, not only just predict, but also intervene and prevent recurrent hospitalizations in such patients. And that's some of the early work that kind of got me really interested in this whole area of changing the way we deliver care in a more continuous fashion rather than a transactional fashion.
Okay, so and speaking of AI, what, in your opinion, is the most promising use of AI in the clinic that you've heard of in your research thus far?
So there are many uses of AI. I think there is, if you want to look at it, there's narrow AI that I just talked about. There's conventional AI, which is more like predictive analytics, where you can look at a surface EKG, and folks are already doing that, and predict which patients are going to develop life-threatening arrhythmias or sudden death or atrial fibrillation many years down the line, just from one look at the surface EKG. So you're not just diagnosing something relevant to that EKG, but you're able to make predictions because AI is able to see deep into the ECG that the human eye cannot. And then there's this whole realm of generative AI that people are really excited about, all the large language models and how they can potentially impact care. I think the earliest way that they will impact care in the clinical realm is going to be some form of liberation from the keyboard, where you walk in, you see your patients, you're able to maintain eye contact with your patients and really engage in a conversation with them, while the generative AI actually provides the opportunity of creating a synthetic note, which you can then subsequently edit. But so you can spend more time examining and looking after your patients. There's a spectrum of activity out there that AI can really help in. I think it's going to be the back end that'll happen early on, the predictive end, which will certainly is already around the corner, but the advice for intervention is going to come a little later on as these technologies get a little more souped up.
You describe a future that is heavily shaped by these types of technologies, but you avoid painting a dystopian picture of the future. So I'm wondering, how do you grapple with some of the potential pitfalls of these technologies while being able to stay optimistic about what they can offer?
No, that's great, Molly. I'm an eternal optimist. So some of my perceptions of how medicine is going to evolve is tempered by some of that optimism. But I do agree that one has to be careful. Because let me take a step back and use the example of the internet. right? When the internet came to being, everybody thought this is going to be the end of the world and machines are going to take over. And, you know, now granted, there have been issues with the internet and identity theft and, you know, cybersecurity issues and ethics and things to that effect. But there are regulatory barriers. There are guardrails that have helped us use the internet and actually advance, human society. I think the same thing with AI, but I think it's imperative for us to really kind of construct the guardrails just as we did for the internet and really ensure that we're tackling with all these issues related to cybersecurity, privacy and bias and ethics and racism and all the other things that, you know, oftentimes can get worsened by a technology that goes, out of hand.
So who is this book for? What do you hope that people will get from it?
Yeah, so this book is for anybody interested in their health. And I think that really amounts to everybody. What I hope people will learn from it is that, you know, there is a digital transformation that is transpiring as we speak. And I think it's really imperative that we become a part of that process, help it adapt to the way we want it to be, and not let it take over our lives. I do think it's really important to recognize that despite this burgeoning metamorphosis of digital technology, the human touch is really important. There's a really lovely saying that the secret of caring for your patient lies in the care for your patient. So I think it's really important to really care for your patients. And the only way to be able to care for your patients is to maintain the digital touch alongside the human touch.
So how do you hope that this book will inform medicine or care delivery?
Well, thank you, Molly. I think it's really important to recognize that just being digitized doesn't transform the care that we're delivering. Being digital is very different from being digitized. Being digital means we really need to change the care pathways for looking after our patients. We're really expanding the value proposition out here in a different form and fashion. And I think it's important to recognize that there will be changes in the transactional mode of care that we deliver into something that's more continuous, so that we can predict and prevent disease. I think there are going to be a lot of shifts in how this care is delivered between academic medical centers and third-party vendors and insurance companies. So it's going to be a really interesting period of time.
Sounds like it. Thank you so much. So we've been talking with Jagmeet Singh about his book, Future Care. Jag, it has been a pleasure speaking with you. Learn more on our website at magazine.hms.harvard.edu.
Thank you, Molly. Thank you for having me.